Hi there, and welcome back to 365 Data Science. In today's lesson, we'll explore the fundamentals of data integration and answer key questions about how data moves through modern systems. We'll cover the core concepts of data integration and why it matters, different integration patterns, including ETL and ELT, real-time versus batch processing approaches, data pipelines and their critical role, and practical considerations for choosing the right integration strategy. Let's dive in. Imagine a busy highway system where vehicles represent data moving from one point to another. Each vehicle has a destination, and the road design determines how fast and efficiently it gets there. This is the essence of data integration, the design that allows data to start at the source and reach its desired destination, going through all the required processing in between. Whether you're processing massive data sets or ensuring real-time updates, data integration is all about bringing data together from different sources into a unified system. Think of it like assembling ingredients for a recipe. Each source provides something unique, but together, they create something powerful. To successfully run data integration, there are several well-known patterns established by the industry that you can choose, depending on your needs. But before we get to them, a quick word about today's lesson. If you're finding this introduction to data architecture helpful, you'll love our comprehensive courses at 365datascience.com. We offer in-depth training at data architecture, data engineering, and building data pipelines from scratch. Our step-by-step approach helps you master these crucial skills at your own pace, with hands-on projects and real-world examples. Now, let's return to our exploration of data integration patterns. The first and most common pattern is called extract, transform, load, often referred to as ETL. The flow of events here is sequential. You first extract the data from its source, clean it up, transform it, and load it into the target system. A modern twist to the regular ETL process is the ELT pattern that stands for extract, load, transform. This is where data is first loaded into a warehouse or data lake and then transformed right where it's stored. This paradigm was developed to handle very high volumes of data. Next is event-driven integration. This pattern is designed for situations where data processing needs to be triggered by the occurrence of specific events. For instance, if a potential fraudulent transaction occurs at an ATM, the bank triggers a workflow to quickly confirm the transaction with the customer. And finally, there's data virtualization. This creates a single, virtual view of data from multiple sources without physically moving it. Before we go deeper into understanding these patterns, it's important to note that data generally arrives in two distinct ways: in real time or in batches. Let's understand the nuances with each. Batch processing is like doing laundry once a week, where data comes in batches and is ingested in periodic time slots. You gather all the data, process it together, and load the results. It's efficient for large volumes of data that don't need immediate updates. On the other hand, real-time processing is like washing dishes as you use them. Data is processed instantly, enabling quick reactions. This is great for use cases like fraud detection or stock trading. A simple example to understand these two data flows would be a streaming service like Netflix that uses batch processing to analyze user preferences overnight, while it runs real-time workflows to deliver content as soon as a user sends a request, or in other words, clicks on the play button. Now, to run these processes, whether in batches or in real time, you need a data flow that runs several steps from gathering data, cleaning it, processing it, and then delivering to the required target system. This workflow that automatically runs all the necessary steps for capturing data and delivering it is called a data pipeline. Let's take a closer look at data pipelines. These are automated workflows that transport and process data from one place to another. Similar to incoming data flows, pipelines are also of two types, segregated by the data they are ingesting. Batch pipelines handle large data sets at scheduled intervals, and streaming pipelines process data continuously in real time. The choice between the two depends on your business needs. Batch pipelines work well for daily reports, while streaming is critical for applications like monitoring IoT devices, where instant, real-time responses are important. So, how do you decide when to use real-time processing data pipeline and when to run processing in batches? There are some guiding questions that can help you decide the right approach. Does the data need to be processed immediately? If yes, go with real-time. Can the data wait for a periodic processing? If it can, then batch processing is your answer. And what is your appetite for balancing cost versus performance? Streaming pipelines with event-driven integrations are usually more resource-intensive and costly, but deliver high performance. Batch processing pipelines are cheaper, but also slower in delivering outputs. Put briefly, data integration is the cornerstone of modern data architecture, enabling organizations to combine, process, and derive value from their data assets effectively. Now let's recap the points we've covered in this lesson. Data integration connects different data sources into unified systems. Common patterns include ETL, ELT, event-driven integration, and data virtualization. Data processing can be real-time or batch-based. Data pipelines automate the flow of data through various processing stages, and the choice of integration strategy depends on the specific business needs and requirements. Well, thank you for joining this video on data integration fundamentals. If you found this information helpful, don't forget to check out our complete course catalog at 365datascience.com for more in-depth training on data architecture and engineering. Until next time, keep learning.